So the Venus zone is a region around a star where we think a planet the size of the Earth could be actually more like Venus than like the Earth. Specifically, the Venus zone is defined by two boundaries. The outer boundary is where you can expect the atmosphere of an Earth-like planet to be pushed into a runaway greenhouse effect. Now the inner boundary is where the radiation pressure from its star will actually start to erode the atmosphere. And so that's where we expect planets to lose their atmosphere. So if the planet is the size of the Earth and it falls in between these two boundaries of the Venus zone, then we know that it's probably more like Venus than like Earth. As we know, the Earth is a very nice place to live, and one of the reasons for that is that we have large amounts of liquid water on the surface. Now for Venus, Venus is extremely different because Venus lost all of its liquid water from its surface a long time ago, and now it has what we call a runaway greenhouse effect going on at the surface. And so it's extremely hot, extremely inhospitable to human life or indeed any kind of life. The boundaries of the Venus zone are mostly determined by the properties of the star. In fact, they're almost completely determined by the properties of the star. One thing to think about is that Venus is about 25% closer to the Sun than the Earth, but it receives almost twice the amount of flux, twice the amounts of solar energy that the Earth receives. That is obviously enough to make Venus substantially different. And so what we've been able to do is generalize our model to different kinds of stars so that now when we look at planets which have been discovered by the Kepler mission, we can then put them into the Venus zone calculated specifically for that star. So looking for exoplanets, I think is one of the fantastic opportunities we have. And our current generation, I believe, is very fortunate to experience this revolution. And that is because this is a quest to address one of the most fundamental questions which has plagued humanity almost since the dawn of humanity. So for thousands of years ago, philosophers like Epicurus speculated about other worlds and popularized this idea of the plurality of worlds. And the only way forward here is exciting, of course, because now that we know that we're there, the next step is to look at the atmospheres of these planets. In future missions, we'll be able to analyze the atmospheres of these planets in great detail, and that's when we really will be able to determine if a planet really is like the Earth, or if it is like our sister planet Venus, and we'll be able to tell that difference and know for certain.